Hello students, today I have prepared a video on a topic called as BGP, Border Gateway Protocol. It is the only protocol which is responsible for exterior gateway protocol. Now what do you mean by exterior gateway protocol? Whenever the two routers of different autonomous system wants to communicate among themselves, BGP is the only routing protocol. If you talk about IGP, Interior Gateway Protocol, we have already discussed the two different routing protocols, which are nothing but RIP and OSPF. So today we are going to talk about the protocol called as Border Gateway Protocol, BGP, treated as EGP, which is Exterior Gateway Protocol. So what is BGP? Border Gateway Protocol is an inter-domain routing protocol using path vector routing. It first appeared in the year 1989 and has gone through four different versions. So here if you see, our BGP lies over here, which is under path vector routing protocol. Now, in case of path vector routing protocol, basically path control of the data is being achieved. Now, the metric which is being considered for routing of the data in case of path vector routing is nothing but the number of autonomous systems which come across the data while going through the source to destination. If you remember well, if you talk about OSPF, the routing metric was nothing but the link bandwidth. If you remember the RIP protocol, the routing metric over there was nothing but the number of hops. Now, we'll try to understand the BGP session. So here if you look carefully, they have shown two different types of BGP session. One is the internal BGP session, which is being shown by the dotted lines, and the other is external BGP session, which is being shown by the solid lines. But what is basically the internal BGP session? The internal BGP session is being formed within the routers which exist within the same autonomous system, while the external BGP session is formed within the routers which supports two different autonomous systems. So here if you see, router A1 and router B1 are from two different autonomous systems and they are forming external BGP session among them. The routers which are forming the external BGP sessions are also treated as the speaker nodes. So here if you see, in autonomous system 1, the speaker node is A1, while in the autonomous 2, the speaker node is B1. BGP is the protocol which is backing the core routing decisions on the internet. It maintains a table of IP networks or prefixes which designate network reachability among autonomous system. If you remember well, what do you mean by autonomous system? Autonomous system are nothing but the group of routers which is being administered or organized by a company or an organization or by a single ISP. BGP is described as path vector protocol. What do you mean by path vector protocol? Which maintains the path information that gets updated dynamically. Now, we'll try to understand about BGP routing process. Most routing protocols receive routing information. So here, if you see diagram, how the routing protocols basically receive this routing information. by receiving the different routes. This received routes are being applied to the input policies. After applying to the input policies, some decision process is being done on it, which is used basically to build and maintain a routing table. So for building and maintaining this routing table, lookup and forwarding process is also being considered. After building the routing table, applying some output policies, this routing table is being shared or being advertised to the other routers to advertise the different routes. So this is the process how the BGP routing process take place. And who does the advertisement of the routes? If you remember, the speaker node. So speaker node is basically used to advertise the different routes. Now, if you look over here, input policies and output policies may filter routes or change the path attributes. So changing of path attributes indicates that BGP supports path control. That's the reason name given to the BGP is path vector routing process. Now, with this, we'll try to understand the different characteristics under path vector routing process, which are concerned with the BGP. First characteristics of BGP or path vector routing process is sharing. A speaker node in an AS share its table with the immediate neighbor. So the first characteristics is what? Sharing. So from this diagram, A1 will share its routing table with the immediate neighbor B1 of different autonomous system. So the first characteristics is nothing but sharing. Next, the next characteristics is updating. Whenever some changes in the routing table are being done, updating is essential. What does it mean? Adding the nodes that are not in its routing table and adding its own autonomous system and the autonomous system that sent the table. The routing table shows the path completely to reach to the destination. So here we have seen the two important characteristics. First is sharing of the routing table to the immediate neighbor and updating the routing table as and when some nodes are being added or some AS is being added to its routing table. The third important characteristic is loop prevention. What do you mean by loop prevention? Whatever the path is being selected to reach to the destination should not turn back to the source again. If that path turns back to the source again, we say it as forming a loop, and with a loop data cannot reach to its destination. So loop prevention is the important characteristics of any routing protocol. And how loop prevention is possible in path vector is a route check to see if its autonomous system is in path list to the destination. So if the route is being checked and if it is found its own AS is there in the path list, then a loop may occur. So a check is being done to make sure that its own AS is not coming into the path list to reach to the destination. Next characteristics is policy routing. To make sure that each and every path reaching to the destination is following its policy or not. If one of the autonomous system listed in the path is against its policy, it can ignore that path and that destination. If it's against, it does not update its routing table with the path and it does not send this message to its neighbor. So path vector routing before updating its routing table or before sending it to the neighbor, it makes sure that all the paths which are reaching to the destination are within the policy or not. So here we have discussed the four important characteristics, which are sharing, updating, loop prevention and policy routing. The last property or characteristic is optimum path. Each AS that is included in the path may use different criteria for metric. The optimum path is the path that fits the organization. So optimum path is the path which fits the organization goal. Now there are three different types of AS, which are stub AS, multi-home AS and transit AS. Stub AS is the AS which has only one connection to another AS. Multi-home AS is the AS which are having more than one connection to the other AS, while transit AS is a multi-home AS that allows transient traffic. At the last, we'll try to understand the different BGP messages, which are nothing but open, update, keep alive and notification. Open message is basically used to establish a pairing session. So to establish a session, it first announces its autonomous ID and then it establishes a pairing session for a determined hold timer. Next BGP message is the update message. This message is used to update with the different routes which are added or removed. So basically it lists the withdrawn routes or announcing new routes. It also responsible for network reachability information and list of reachable prefixes. The third message is keep alive message, which is similar with handshaking protocol. Send periodically to peers to ensure connectivity, to make sure that the neighbor is connected and alive. Send in place of an update message. And the last message is notification. Notification is used whenever there is some error and need to be notified to the neighbor router. So basically it is used for error notification or shutting down the peering session. TCP connection is closed immediately after notification. So these are very important points to be noted. The different BGP messages, which are nothing but open, update, keep alive and notification. So what are the functional procedures for it? Basically these four messages are some or the other way responsible for neighbor acquisition, neighbor reachability and network reachability. Neighbor acquisition is possible with the help of open message and keep alive message, while neighbor reachability is possible by periodic sending of keep alive message, and network reachability is possible just because of broadcasting of an update message. Now one has to remember that all these BGP messages are being sent over TCP connection on port number 179. With this, I am ending a very important topic called as BGP, which comes under Path Vector Routing Protocol, and it is the only protocol which supports EGP, which stands for Exterior Gateway Routing Protocol. Thank you.